Let's have a chat about the power of money. Based upon my last video, there were some people who were like, hey, Glendon, what about the FIRE movement? What about Warren Buffett? They're investors. Actually, Warren Buffett is a business owner. Berkshire Hathaway is a holding company. Bad example. You should do your research like I do. So let's talk about the FIRE movement. Because I started laughing out loud when that was like the FIRE movement. Well, they get big dividends. Do you know if you had $1 million in a dividend stock portfolio, that $1 million would make you $35,000 to $50,000 in 1 year? In my opinion, that ain't really that much of a return. Like, I know there are some, get those juicy dividends because I don't have to do nothing. So if you wanted to have adequate retirement on dividend stock portfolios, you would need $2 to $3 million working in the stock market. And there are people who do that. There are some people who are getting $200,000 to $300,000 a year in dividend income because they have so much money to work. Now, let's take this 1 million. If you gave a good skilled operator, an entrepreneur, $1 million, he could turn that $1 million into $10 million in 3 to 5 years. Big difference. So let's take 3 years. Let's say you gave this entrepreneur $1 million cash. It took him 5 years to turn that into $10 million. You have your dividend stock portfolio, and let's say you're getting $50,000 a year. 5 years is $250,000 versus $10 million. See, what y'all don't understand is the power of money. I was having this conversation many years ago with someone, and I was like, if I put money in a business, what should I expect as a return? And they said 7 to 10%. So as an investor, you need a lot of money to get juicy return with 7 and 10% returns. So if you put $1 million in this investment and you got a 10% return, that would be $100,000. If you had a $10 million investment, you got a 10% return, that would be $1 million. Income and money is a lever. The bigger the lever, the greater the return. So, you know, I had people in there was talking about like Warren Buffett. I was like, Warren Buffett is a business owner. He owns Berkshire Hathaway. He's not just like, he's an institutional investor. He's not some guy in his basement studying stock charts. I'm gonna break it down like I should have broken it down in the last video. Who I'm talking to are these people who've had a little bit of success in the stock market, Forex, and they're talking to me as if I should abandon what I'm doing to jump into Forex. Cause see, I don't really talk about how much money I make. And I had someone's like, hey dude, you know, you have a high income, but that doesn't mean you're wealthy. What happened to me last year? I had a heart attack. Did I have to move? Did my cars get repossessed? No. Let's talk about my friend who has a property management business. She wanted to get rid of it. She wanted to sell it and get like $300,000. And I convinced her not to do it and to hire someone. Now this business, it was doing $500,000 a year, does well over $2 million a year. My friend who goes in the office like once a week because she's got a team and a system. See, this is the thing that you guys don't understand, because investing is sexy. Forex is sexy. Day trading's sexy. You know, it's nothing sexier than rolling out of bed, checking your phone, looking at some stock charts and making money and not having to do anything. Let me give you some real game. If you create a business, let's say you're 21 years old and you start a business, and by the time you're 35, you have built this business, you have put systems, processes, and you've hired the right people, guess what? You can sit at home like my buddy Michael, who's done this. Michael has created a multi-million dollar business, and he was at home so much his neighbors thought he was retired. Because you don't want to do anything, and you want to sit here and argue with me because I'm in these economic streets. I'm making money. If folks want to like argue with me and say all this other stuff and understand, and I'm going to say this, and this is going to make me the lightest, elitist motherfucker. You're not where I'm at. You're not on my level. You don't see the kind of money I see. You can't even imagine the kind of money I see. Get out your feelings, because your daddy is trying to tell you something that if you would get out your feelings and listen, and more importantly, don't just listen, apply the knowledge, it'll change your life. Cause see, investors, the richest man in the world, Jeff Bezos, did he get there through investing? No, he owns a business. The second richest man in the world, I think it's Bill Gates. Did he get there investing? No, he owns a business. Zuckerberg's up there, because if you go ahead and do a quick Google search and do the top 50 as wealthiest people in the world, you will see the majority of them who did not inherit their wealth, who built it on their own, are business owners. And y'all keep wanting to like, well, Forex and the FIRE movement. Let's talk about the FIRE movement. This is what I see with the FIRE movement. I see people living pathologically cheap, doing super frugal things so they can put so much money in the market. And then once they put money in the market, they're still pathologically cheap. They have to live on a certain budget. And if the market shifts, they have to cut their budget. I've seen this on the YouTube videos. I've seen this. There is a couple, Our Rich Journey. I feel that what they've done is a wonderful job. They were able to retire. I think they have a $2 million portfolio. But let's look at this. Where did they retire? Portugal. They bought a house in Portugal with their two children. Why did they move to Portugal? Because the cost of living is cheaper. I live in Atlanta, Georgia. I can live anywhere I want to in these United States of America and I can live well. I don't have to move to Portugal. I don't have to move to some place where the cost of living is cheaper. See, once again, corporate citizens, hear me and hear me well. You can design the life that you want if you're willing to roll up your sleeves and go to work. You can live the kind of life that you want to. You don't have to live a life of confinement and living in a framework, because I've said it before and I'm gonna say it again. You're gonna manage your money or your money's gonna manage you. And I'm telling you, the way your money gonna treat you like a bitch. That's what your money's gonna treat you like. Your money ain't gonna have no respect for you. Your money is just gonna be slapping you upside your head. So you need to get in a position where you manage your money, where you are the architect of your destiny. And like I said, there are people, like someone put in there, like the top 1% owns like most of the stock. 1%, that's a small group of people. And because it's possible, like, let's just go ahead and talk about possibilities. You could buy a lottery ticket and win $500 million tomorrow. It is possible. It can happen. But the question is it likely? No, it's not. It's not gonna happen. Someone's gonna buy a lottery ticket and they're gonna win. But the odds against you winning, they're not that good. They're not that good at all. So what I'm trying to tell you is to let all of this quick money, low effort stuff go. I know there are people out there who are whispering in your ear, you know what? If you enroll in my program, you could be with Big Booty Betty all day long. Yeah, you can. You'd be rubbing on that booty all day long. Yes, you can. You could work 4 hours a day and make a six-figure income. So you have all this day to spend with your family, this day to go to the beach, all of this time to just sit around and chill. Those folks are whispering sweet nothings into your ear. You know, like these guys will whisper to these young pretty girls like, hey man, I'll take care of you. These things they're whispering aren't true for the lion's share of people who would try them. I did a video. Amazon FBA has a 92% failure rate. Day trading has a 99% failure rate. And Forex has a 99% failure rate. But people still jumping in because it's sexy. It's so sexy. Let me just go ahead and make a recommendation. Everyone that's watching this video is here on YouTube, someone told me. Start listening to Earl Nightingale Lead the Field and get your level of service up so you can get your income up. Because I'm here to tell you, the odds of you becoming a big dog investor with large dividends and big returns out the lever of a lot of money is never gonna happen. Google it. Fact check me. Google the returns on the $1 million dividend portfolio. Now, let's go ahead and talk about this, because I looked at the dividend portfolio and I looked at real estate. A dividend portfolio of $1 million is gonna have a yield of $38,000 to $50,000 per year. $1 million. Let's take that same million and buy four pieces of real estate that you can get, let's see, $250,000. You can get $2,500 per month for those four pieces of real estate, okay? So that's $10,000 a month, $120,000 a year. Let's do the real math. Let's include property taxes. Let's include taxes. So you're gonna probably pay $2,000 to $3,000 property taxes for each one of those properties. So let's go ahead and make it a nice round three. So you're gonna pay $12,000 in property taxes. You're gonna pay taxes on that money. Unless you take the corporate toolbox and learn how to clean it up, you're gonna lose about $20,000 of that money. Same, $1 million. You're gonna have $100,000 to spend versus a dividend stock portfolio. Wait a minute, hold up. What do we know about real estate? The property values go up. So the more expensive the house is, you get to raise the rents. So periodically, you're going to get a raise with your real estate investment. Once again, it's just $1 million. So let's say you're not getting a raise with your dividend stock portfolio. And in times of crises, many of these companies that issue a dividend will suspend or stop their dividend. So if you own $1 million in dividend stock and $1 million in real estate. Now, with real estate, you're gonna have vacancies, you're gonna have expenses, you're gonna have management stuff, but at the end of the day, you're gonna make twice as much money with the real estate investment as you would with dividend. The only advantage with a dividend stock portfolio, in my eyes, is you can sell it really quick. It's liquid. You can, like, if you need to raise some money, you want to raise $250,000, you can sell that in the morning, have your $250 by lunch. Other than that, I don't see the advantages of a dividend stock portfolio for me. You may like that action. You may like living on a constrained budget. You might like living in fear when the markets churn and your dividend is suspended. You might like all that. I like the business cash. And I'm trying to tell you, I'm trying to hip you, and you like, well, there's some ways you can make money. Let's just keep it on. You ain't gonna make that much money, because you don't have no money right now. You're not gonna make that much money. Once again, what did I just say? If you want to have juicy returns, you're gonna need a lot of money invested. So if you wanted to have a good retirement, you would need about $3 million in dividend stock to give you over six figures in retirement income. And oh yeah, during that example where I was taking out the taxes, the dividend income is gonna be taxed at 15% capital gains tax. It ain't, I mean, any way you look at it, the real estate beats it, the business income beats it, but let's go ahead and talk about you starting the business at 21, hiring the right team. Like, this is a guy in Inc. magazine, this was an article years ago. He actually traveled the world with his family and left his team to run his business. Guess what happened? When he came back, the business was doing better than when he left. See, one of the things that you guys don't understand, because you lazy, trying to cheat, trying to rent seek, trying to cheat the system, figure out a way to extract a lot of money out of the system without working, you don't understand that you can build a business, put systems and processes in place, and it'll be just like retirement, except you getting a big check because you own the business. Someone that came to me was like, hey, you know, there's all these things you can do, because I understand you millennials, you young whippersnappers, you think you know more than me, but you don't. You know how I know? The way you live. If you knew more than me, you'd be living better than me. That's called receipts. If you knew more than me, you'd be living better than me. Since you ain't living better than me, you don't know more than me. And I'm gonna start pushing this point with the pushback, because I get all these folks who are in their feelings. Yeah, you know, there is someone with a lot of money, an institutional investor who's getting massive returns from the market, but they're sitting on tens of millions of dollars, in some cases, billions of dollars. Because when money works, you're gonna get a 7 to 10% return. Now let's talk about the returns of a business owner. Remember, if you give a well-seasoned entrepreneur $1 million cash, you can turn that in 10 millions in 3 to 5 years. You can't do that in the stock market. You can't do that. I started this channel with a $285 investment. I did not reinvest for 2 years because I didn't know what I was doing. If I knew what I was doing, I would have bought a better camera off the rip. I made $62,000 my first year. I made $92,000 my second year off of that $285 capital investment. And then I had massive sweat equity. And in my third year, I made $1.5 million. Let's talk about that. Why is $1.5 million in a year significant? You know why it's significant? It takes the average person a lifetime working 40 to have 50 years to make that same money. And I did that in 1 year. And I've had other million-dollar years. So once again, let's dispense with like, yeah, you can do it. But the question is, are you? Because if you want to mess around in the stock markets, that's your leisure. But you're looking at a long, long, long runway. You're looking at to being older than I am so you can ball out on your money. That's what you're looking at. Or you can buckle down, start a business and get juicier returns, because like money is powerful. If you invest money in the market or real estate, you're going to get a 7 to maybe 15% return, well, on the high side with real estate, which is a good return. But you invest in a business, you can get a 1,000% return. You can get a 2,000% return. You can get a 5,000% return. See, this is why business owners are the biggest investor, because they have the money. I was having this conversation, I had to block this dude. Well, I'm an investor. If you have no money in the bank, you're not an investor. You are a finangler. You finagle stuff. You're like that woman, like in the Eddie Murphy skit. Johnny Carson, we have 500 million and she's like, I have 30,000. Now we have 500 million and 30,000. That's what you are. You're a finagler. You're not an investor. You can't be an investor with no money. And this is why investors walk, talk, and live differently. Because there are some big dog investors out there with millions of dollars in their investments, and they're getting some great returns, but they have millions of dollars in their investments. Let's talk about why half the country only makes $33,000 a year. You wanna know why half the country only makes $33,000 a year? They don't know what they don't know. They don't know that they can start an internet business and make six figures. They don't know this. They have no clue. But this is the majority of people in America make less than $75,000 a year because they don't know what they don't know. And I'm here to tell you, I'm here to school you, I'm here to educate you. Investing should be a supplement of a robust active income program, because you can do in a business in 3 to 5 years what you can do in 30 to 50 years of investing. Investing should be a supplement. But the main course, the steak, the potatoes, the asparagus on your plate should be a business, because business owners make more money. Facts. Go to Google and go through the top 50 richest people in the world, and you will see that they all own businesses. All of them. They're not investors. And Warren Buffett owns Berkshire Hathaway, which is a holding company. What I've been telling y'all, I've been trying to induce, seduce, and bring you over to the corporate citizen side. The holding company game is some of the tightest game on the planet. With that, I am going to add the YouTube course to the holding game, the corporate citizen. I'm gonna do that sometime this month, because we're gonna get into that. So if you wanna become a corporate citizen, if you wanna change your financial life in the next 3 years, go below, hit the link you can get into for a one-time fee of $3,500, or you can get on the monthly payment plan, which I'm pretty sure that I'm gonna change in November. So you wanna go ahead and get in now. So that's all I got for you savages, and I will see you in the next video.